Hey, horse people. This is the legendary Alamar knot that legend or stories, or if you talk to the old vaqueros, a Finnish bridle horse could supposedly be ridden in one of these. And you basically make it out of a rope and you put it around his neck. And then this sits there at the chest of the horse, and you can actually ride him. So you're basically riding with a loop around the neck. It's just a pretty knot, and it used to symbolize a finished horse. So I'm going to show you how to tie this sucker, because it's a pain, and I haven't tied. I've had this one for a long time. I've ridden Buddy with it, Mr. T with it, and I made it out of one of my old rappel ropes, and I put a little bell right there. So I can stick it on Buddy and hear where he's at night, as long as he don't take it off, because he's a little pooper. Anyway, so I'm going to tie one of these. I have done research high and low. Nobody's done a video on this. So if you find a video on this knot after I've done this, I mean, it's just amazing that nobody's done this knot, and you can't find it anywhere. There's a couple little cheap drawings that aren't that great, but there absolutely is no videos on the Alamar knot. So what I've done is I've made a pretzel knot, and I just noticed my battery was a little low, so I'm going to stick a power source on here to make sure that I don't lose my battery. So again, Alamar knot, it's very complicated if you don't know, if somebody tries to explain it to you. I don't think it's that complicated, but I've done it a few times, and I kind of forgot because I hadn't done it in a while. So basically what you want to do is I'm going to try to, so I can watch this and make sure that I'm in a view here. I talk about my repelling knots where I'm showing how to repel and how to do things like that. You want to make a knot look finished. So when the knot is finished, I'm going to try to zoom in on here a little bit. When this knot is finished, you want to make sure that the two ropes here are in line. There's two coming out here. There's two coming out here. And this little loop here is kind of your center of the rope, or the center of the rope. Now, I'm going to use this rope here, and what I've done is I've tied a yellow and a red rope together to simulate the center of the rope. Now, obviously this rope, the center, I folded it in half and I got the center. And that's how I did it. And you can adjust it afterwards. And this one, I just untied one of my halters and took the lead rope off and decided to tie a quick Alamar knot. So there's your knot. If you want to put something on here, you've got to do it before you tie it, because you can't get it on afterwards unless you can clip around here. But if it's round, it needs to go on before. And then your loop, again, is adjustable. I don't know if I can get out of here. This goes around the horses, so you'll make this smaller or larger. So how long your rope is when you do this, and I know somebody's at it right now, just show us how to tie the knot. Quit talking. Look. Try and explain this. It's a sensitive knot. If you can go find it somewhere else, go find it. So I've just got a little square knot right there. You need to ignore that knot right there. This square knot is not part of the Alamar knot. So this square knot is basically this circle part here, or this circle part here. Except it has a little square knot because I have two. So I'm going to untie this knot. And we're going to have just one solid rope. Untying this sucker is harder than tying it. All right. So basically, this is a solid rope that we're going to see right here. Okay? I've got it tied with two, so we got two colors to kind of helpfully explain a little bit more. But when this rope started out, it's just one solid rope. This is one solid rope, and I basically started with the middle. So since I tied these in the middle and they're both the same size, this is the middle of my rope, so this is going to be end up on the Alamar knot here, like it was tied. So to get your middle of the rope when you start this knot, basically you find your middle of the rope, and I'm going to try to keep this so you can kind of see it. So I got the middle of the rope here. I better zoom out a little bit. So you make your little loop and you start with it at the top. And then you're going to make what some people call a pretzel knot. And the pretzel knot is basically, I'm going to roll this piece over here like so. Or I can roll this piece over here like so. Okay? So when you start this knot, I'm going to go ahead and roll this knot, which is going to be over here. I've tried to get this as high as I can, so I'm filming down, but it's not directly on top, so my hands may get in the way here. So I have this loop right here, and now I'm going to have this loop over here. But that's just starting it, because I need to make sure I go under and over like I'm supposed to. So on this knot, I'm going under. You notice this red rope is underneath this yellow rope. And this red rope here is over this rope, and then here's where you start going under and over. So I have my two loops here. This is the center of the rope. It's going to be the finish knot. So this is kind of called a pretzel knot. So if you look up pretzel knot, you can probably see what this is. So now what I need to do is, because I'm going over here, I'm going under here. The red rope is under here. The red rope is over here. I don't want to be over and over, so I have to go under here. So I got to slide this under this rope. And now I still have my little pretzel knot. So I went over there. So now I went under here. My next rope, I got to go over. Now I got to go under this rope. And over that rope. So that's kind of what my little pretzel knot, or this is kind of like called it, like a single Alamar. So what you have right there is what it should look like in between. Okay, so hopefully you can see that. You notice this goes under the rope, over the rope, under the rope, over the rope, under the rope, over the rope, under the rope, over the rope. So once I have this here, again, this is the center. This is going to be the bottom of my finish. Now I have these two ends here. And this is going to make my loop. So basically, this is going to come around this way, and this is going to come around this way. Okay? So there's my loop there. Now, what I need to do is I need to trace the rope that's already there. So basically, I'm going to take this rope here, which is why I got the colored one. I'm going to follow this yellow rope, so when it goes under, over, whatever, I'm going to stay right with that rope. So the yellow rope is under. I'm going under. The yellow rope is over. I'm following that yellow rope, so I'm going over. Now that would be wrong, because this is over and the yellow rope's under, so I got to go under that rope. I'm following a yellow rope, following a yellow brick road. The yellow rope curves around, it goes under there. So I go under, again, following the yellow rope. Need to get a little bit more slack there because I need more room to work. So I'm following that around, going under, it goes over that rope. So this goes over, it goes under the yellow there. So I go under the yellow, and it goes right back down to the center there. So this center piece here is going to be one of these pieces right here. If I turn this upside down, this will be the loop, and now I have two coming out right here. You see this red rope here? That's that rope. You see that going into the loop? That's that rope. I don't know if you could see that. I was kind of out of the way there. Sorry about that. Again, this rope right here and the yellow rope is these two ropes right here. Now this single over here is just this single part right here. So now I need to trace this yellow rope back. So since this is going to be the top part of my loop, let me zoom back out here. Since this is going to be the top part of my loop, I need to follow this red rope because it's single. You notice I have a double rope here, double, 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 but I have this single rope running around here. Now I'm going to take this yellow rope and follow this only single rope that I got. So it goes over these two, then it goes under, now it goes over because it's over right there, then it's under here, so I got to go under. Again, I'm just tracing this rope. It goes over these two, so I'm taking it. I'm going over these two, goes under those two, I'm going under, goes over those two, so I got to come back, go over those two, and then it goes under right there, so I got to go under here. And that's your Alamar knot. Looks like crap because I haven't finished it, and I always talk about finishing a knot. You need to make a knot look neat. So now I'm going to finish this by just pulling on my center rope here and these two ropes here, and I'm going to just make it tight. Okay? So I'm kind of, this is called finishing the knot. I'm just kind of removing some of the slack. I don't want to remove too much because then I'll lose the consistency. And now I'm going to spin it back around. And there's my Alamar knot, and this is the bottom. So what you're looking at here is the Alamar knot here. Here's the bottom. Here's the bottom. Now this looks really big right here. And again, this is where the finishing part comes in. Because now I can make this knot, if I want to make this smaller, once you have the basic knot to where it looks neat and is finished, now I can adjust. I can make these longer or shorter. Some people used to use these as a get-down rope. So they would want this rope as a lead rope. So what I would do with this is I would make this longer and then I would shorten this up. So I'm going to shorten this loop up by sliding my yellow rope in and just pulling it to where it's there. Then I'm going to slide my yellow rope here, and I've kept my knot, and now I've shortened that side. So now I'm going to shorten this red side, shorten my red side. Now I'm going to slide that knot around and pull on here, and I'm still keeping my finished knot. So now now this is more small. Now you notice my center's kind of off center there, so I need to shorten up this red one some more. So I'm going to shorten up the red one a little bit more, pulling the red there, pulling the red there, pulling the red there. And now I'm just going to kind of pull on them all and get them kind of the way I want them. And that's my finished knot. Now, I don't think this is a good enough finished knot because if I zoom in here, you're going to see I want this knot to be like it's supposed to be. So these two should be in a line and they should be flat and they should be flat and they should follow flat, flat, yellow, red, yellow, red. So it finishes the way it's supposed to. This other knot here, it goes red, yellow, red, yellow. You notice how it's crossed over right there? So that's not finished. So what I need to do is I need to bring this red over this yellow so it looks uniform and it's finished. And now I have yellow, red, and yellow, red. And then I can just continue to tighten it up. And that's my Alamar knot. All right? Practice it. You can go over it. This is what it looks like when it's just a lead rope. It's right here. I can hang this over. You notice I have the two. When you have a finished Alamar knot, you're going to have two over here, two over here, two here, two here, two here, two here, two there, and two there. Can't have any single ropes. The only single rope is the one at the bottom down here. So that's a finished Alamar. That's a finished Alamar. And this is a finished Alamar. And that's your Alamar knot. And I am shocked out of all the videos on all the channels, and if you Google Alamar knot, how to tie this sucker, nobody shows you. So now I've showed you. Feel free to share it. It's a nice knot. Again, if I wanted to make this longer, let's say I want to make this longer to make this a tie-down rope, then I would just find where this rope goes. And when I tied it, now I have a nice tie-down rope. So I can make this as long as I want. And this can be my get-down rope. So when this is over my horse's head, I have a rope here. This one just kind of knows nowhere, and this finishes. Again, my little square knot here, you need to ignore that. That's just, again, to show you the middle of the knot. So now I have a get-down rope. Now if I finish the knot and it looks like this, and I'm like, crap, that don't look good. Well, then I know I need to shorten this rope up, so basically you just track it back. I'm going to shorten it to the length I want it. If I want it to come right down to the finish there, I'll shorten it there. I'll feed it in here. And now I've shortened it. And I've still maintained my consistency of this. Now the yellow one's too long. If I want to shorten it, I'm going to feed it through to where I want to shorten it. Pull it tight. And now I've shortened that one. And I've still maintained my consistency of my Alamar knot. Okay? Hope that helps on the how to tie an Alamar knot.
If the lighting wasn't good or you couldn't see, sorry about that. I tried to do the best I could. That's the little finish guy, so you can look at it. That's a finished one. And that's a finished one. The legendary Alamar knot. Now there's a video about it, because nobody else put one out there. All right, hope that helps. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.